I recently picked up the hobby of speedrunning, and I was fortunate enough to set my first world record today, playing Hot Wheels Stunt Track Driver for the Game Boy Color. The Game Boy version differs quite a bit from its PC-exclusive Big Brother, and given how different my strategy was from the last record holder, I thought I'd turn uploading the run into an opportunity to talk about the game and explain how this fun speedrun works. Surprisingly, I discovered that the best tactic is actually not to be fast. It's to be purposefully mediocre. Time starts when you press A on the car select screen. The game is divided into 6 levels. Each level lasts around a minute and a half, but usually less. At first, running this game was a frustrating, seemingly random experience in which your own skills seem to matter a lot less than RNG. When you cross the line at the end of the race, you have to wait for the two AI opponents to cross as well, unless they're so incredibly far behind that the game gives up and shows you the flag after about 10 seconds. This means that segments like Bedroom here end up being around a minute 22 to a minute 26, even if you cross the line around the minute 12 mark. The previous world record holder was plenty fast through Bedroom, but spent time waiting, and thus finished with a 125. During my roughly 7 hours with the game, I discovered that the attempts where I made a lot of mistakes and won by the skin of my teeth were often my fastest times. Then, while struggling with crashing too much in Kitchen, I started experimenting with just holding A and not doing stunts through the difficult parts of that level. This is slower since you gain speed when stunting, but it's safe. With the exception of 1 or 2 jumps, you were always safe just holding A. I noticed again that doing this improved my times. This led to the conclusion that the AI in this game are programmed to speed up when you make mistakes, or go slowly instead of stunting, in order to add difficulty and pressure you to speed up and play the game as intended. By sandbagging, we're able to keep the AI in very close proximity to us. While I do lose about 2-3 seconds from my normal finish time by driving slower, it's more than made up for by the reduced to eliminated time I spend waiting for the AI to arrive. As soon as both opponents cross the line, the flag waves and we're on to the next section. Starting in Living Room, the AI are a bit more aggressive. I determined that a very good approach to my sandbagging strategy is to get a good distance on the opponents by stunting at the very beginning. Then, when they start to finally catch up, I'll stunt just enough to keep them off my screen. This gives me enough wiggle room to recover in case I make a mistake, but also keeps the AI close enough to avoid time loss. You can see I crash quite a few times during the run. As much as I'd like to say these are all on purpose, most of them aren't. The nice thing about the sandbagging strategy is that it allows you to make plenty of mistakes. Thanks to our manipulation, the AI are moving slowly, so if you mess up, you can start trying for just a few seconds, and then get ahead. There were times that I had to reset because I lost the race. Stunting in this game can be difficult. After all, difficulty stunting is why I ended up discovering the sandbagging tactic in the first place. Something you may have noticed is that I sometimes lose speed when landing. Like most side-scrolling racers like this, your angle when landing matters. Having an imperfect angle won't make you wipe out, but it will drop your speed just a teensy bit. Sometimes I correct and land full speed, but a lot of the time I make the decision not to. For one thing, the D-pad input is imprecise, especially in an emulator. The Xbox One controller's D-pad is pretty terrible to start with, and the emulation just complicates it further. I'd rather not risk overcompensating on a fast jump and wiping out over the millisecond time loss. Other times, I just elected not to correct, simply to avoid getting too far ahead of the AI. Personally, I had more trouble training my muscle memory for Backyard than any other stage in the game. As you saw a minute ago, even in this world record run, I wiped out several times in the first few seconds. Part of me wants to say that the track color is too close to some background elements like the dump truck and the cranes, but I know I just lose focus during this stage really easily. This is far from my best Backyard run, and I'm gonna blame that on this being only the second or third run of the session. In future runs, I feel like I can definitely improve this stage massively. As a matter of fact, none of the splits in this run were my best except for Barn, which as you may have noticed, doesn't have a previous best time. That's because in my personal best run, I split too early, about 5 seconds before the actual win screen. I deleted this split so my next personal best would be accurate. Game Room is a very technical stage, but also a very easy one to recover should you make a mistake. The AI seemed to have a lot of trouble with Game Room, and I was able to master after only a couple of attempts. This stage is perhaps one of the worst offenders for a particular glitch I encountered several times, where landing a double or triple flip on certain ramps in certain spots causes your car to clip through the track and plummet to the ground. Sometimes this can be beneficial, and sometimes it can kill runs. In this run, it was pretty neutral. I was slowed down significantly, but the respawn still put me safely in front of the AI opponent, and I was able to push him off the screen in short order. The last section has some glitches I encountered during one of my earlier runs before I started sandbagging. I found one I yet to replicate, wherein landing on a particular spot on the track just before the last two small ramps leading to the finish line flung me over the finish line so high and fast that I couldn't even come close to touching the ground before leaving the screen. This glitch was fun and cool, but didn't help my time, as I then had to wait for the AI to catch up. As I got closer and closer to world record pace, Kitchen was the stage that gave me the most trouble. I was able to win the race every time when going full speed, but when I started sandbagging, I discovered that the stage is the exact inverse of Game Room. Whereas the AI struggled to keep up in Game Room, they seemed to make little to no mistakes in Kitchen. Making one mistake would sometimes mean that the AI would immediately pass you. Then, frantically trying to catch up before the end, I would make more mistakes and fall further behind. The problem is amplified by the layout of the track, where there are fewer places to safely stunt in the latter half of the level. The run died here many times in my later attempts. Eventually, I was able to squeak by with the win, but I still feel as if it was mostly luck and not skill that got me through Kitchen in the first place. With that being said, I finished absolutely neck and neck with the AI, and I feel improving in any way whatsoever would be a very long, frustrating process involving a lot of luck. On to Barn. I've only been playing this game since yesterday, and thus I haven't had a whole lot of time to practice outside of just timing my runs. I've only actually finished Barn one other time before this run, on the run where I messed up my split and rendered the run inadmissible. With that being said, Barn is a simple and rather easy stage, and it gave me no serious difficulty other than simply needing to attempt it again to learn the layout. I used save states to practice Kitchen and Barn about 5 times each before starting my final full session, and I feel like it afforded me the familiarity I needed. I took this run the Barn very carefully, sandbagging very hard not to minimize time loss but to ensure that I safely finished the stage. At this point, I had secured world records, so as long as I didn't lose the race, I wasn't worried about being a couple seconds slower if it meant finally finishing the run with a good time. Barn could probably be slightly improved, but all in all, I feel very satisfied with this run. It took more effort than I thought it was going to, but I wasn't expecting to discover such a radically different strategy from what the previous record holder used. I strongly encourage those who are new to speedrunning or just looking for a fun, short game to play your speedrun to check out this game. The GBC version and the PC version are both fun and deceptively challenging for games made for children. Also, I'd like to plug the Hot Wheels Series Speedrun Discord server. They're a small but dedicated community that run a variety of games in the franchise. Lastly, thank you for watching. I'm currently working on lots more content for both my Twitch and YouTube, including speedruns, traditional video essay format, and other new things. I had a hell of a spring semester, but with things slowing down in the summer, I hope to get my time better organized to ensure I can sustainably produce quality content for both of my channels. Words can't describe how much I miss making videos, so I'm excited to get back to it. Make sure to follow me on Twitch if you aren't already, and join my Discord, too. Thanks again, and have a good night.